What a photo.
I want to thank every single person in this room and all the people that you represent for an amazing race. I just called John Cranley and congratulated him on winning this mayor's race. And I did tell him that, one, he said we scared the hell out of him, which is great. But I did tell him that he has a responsibility. We've shown him his responsibility to serve the people first. And I'm going to be number one making sure he does that, right? And I need you to help me too, all right? I think what we showed Cincinnati is that there's a whole lot of people in Cincinnati who are waiting on the world to change, and you can't ignore those people, that a great city is a city that takes care of everyone. And I expect John Cranley over the next 4 years to make sure he does not ignore the people who need him most. And I think what this race has shown him is that if he doesn't, he's going to have someone chasing his tail again, and it might just be me again in 4 years. So I want to make sure I say some thank yous. One, I want to congratulate all the amazing council people who are going to win, and I want to encourage them to be as sharp and as strong and as holding this administration as accountable as I have. Don't let up. People are counting on you. So those council people, I'm counting on you to make sure you raise the issues. You're going to make sure you represent everyone and make sure that over the next 4 years, we don't lose ground in making sure that every Cincinnatian has a better life and a better living. All right? So I just want to thank this amazing team who got us here. Check out this team. Our campaign manager, Amanda Thorne, field director, Nelson Pierce, communications director, Chaka Baramo, finance director, Molly Goldberg. Give them a round of applause. I want to thank my amazing advisor, Elder Cynthia Turner, who has been my spiritual advisor, my friend through all of this. We're really proud of how we ran this race. We could have gone ugly. We could have gone dirty. We could have thrown mud. We didn't do any of that. We didn't tell any lies. We didn't attack anybody's character. We talked about a brighter future for the city. And guess what? It's always about how you run. And I'm proud of how we ran, no matter the result. So I want to thank my pastor, Bishop David Thomas is here. I want to thank all of our advisors, all of our team members. They're surrounding me. I want to thank all of you. And I want to thank this man right here, the love of my life, Joe Hoffecker. Get out here. My amazing partner, who has been by my side through all of this, always encouraging me. We're going to go to Cancun for 10 days, so, you know, just don't set the city on fire while we're gone, okay? And I'm going to pray about what God would have me do next. You know, what this has exposed me to is that there is a great need for my voice in this city. That the power of we is so needed in this city. What you guys showed me is that there's a whole part of the city that wants positive, that wants forward moving, that wants our city to be a greater city and is not going to settle for good enough. So I thank you all for inspiring me to take this role. We were outraged, we were out endorsed, and we ran one hell of a race, and I'm proud of all of us. How you guys feeling? So I just want to thank you all so much. You're going to see me. We're not going anywhere. We're going to finish out our term through January 1st. We're going to turn it over, and then we're going to figure out how the hell I'm going to make sure this city is exactly what I promised you. Because I actually keep my promises, and I plan to do it whether I'm in the mayor's seat or not. Thank you all. I love you all. Thank you so much. Thank you. Say what? Drink. The party, as you know me, the party's not over. Let's continue to celebrate, and let's remember that tomorrow's going to be a bright day, and we're going to continue to do the work that we need to do in this city to make our city a greater city for everyone. God bless you.